To the wise, to the senior executives at PSP Investment, we've had visits and discussions with the representatives of PSP Investments who've tried to convince us that bonuses are based on a four-year analysis, that it would be appropriate and acceptable if they were to vote themselves bonuses this year. We want to be perfectly clear. It would be absolutely unacceptable for the senior executives at PSP Investments to vote themselves bonuses after the huge losses of the past year, and especially in this grave time of economic crisis. So a word to the wise on that subject as well.
Alors nous passons à la période des questions. I have a question for you, if you don't mind. C361, you discussed stopping the practice of gambling on the markets with workers' wages. I'm just wondering if you might be able to go into some detail about the mechanisms that you'd employ, what kind of investment mechanism would replace existing ones. If you could maybe just talk a little bit about the mechanics of how pension funds would work.
Well, the bill's intention is to ensure that the Public Sector Pension Investment Board Act provides that the board only makes those investments that are low risk and is enacted in a way that has supervision. Now, we want them to, as I just said, to invest in low risk, having regards to the to where the market's at the time, but we need to have regulations. The board of directors shall establish, and the board and subsidiaries shall adhere to, investment policy standards and procedures that a person with substantial prudence would exercise in dealing with the property of others. Because in the past, it's been the Wild West, so to speak, in the pension markets in the last years. And I think that was fed to some degree because people thought the bubble of the market would never burst. And of course, it certainly has in a huge way. And because of the imprudence in the United States with derivatives and putting our main funds at risk, and the contraction in those pension funds is visible across Canada. But we also need to have reporting that goes back to the owners of these plans, where they can see how the investments have been made, and that's part of what's in C-361.
Thank you. S'il y a d'autres questions, Fish?
How widespread is the pension problem? How many pensioners do you expect are affected across Canada, and what would be the scenario if legislation such as what you're tabling isn't adopted?
Well, I don't think that there's a pension plan in this country that is not in some serious jeopardy at this point in time. One of the better situated plans is CPP, and it contracted at a rate of about 13% in this last term. So the reality is that you start looking at like the Ontario Teachers Pension Plan, $80 billion in assets. They've lost $21 billion in assets. So the reality is that's one of the better managed programs. You can, if you look at the plans across the piece, you'll find that worst. And I've already alluded to the concerns with Air Canada and Canadian National. So every plan is at risk at this point in time. There isn't one that you can say is secure. There's another point I'd like to add. You have, like, in a situation in Hamilton where you have laid off workers, 2,000 facing an unknown future. One of the things that we heard at the meeting today that was very important was a talk about the fact from some of our actuaries who said that in the time of a bankruptcy, that workers should come first in the line of assets protection. This is something the NDP and others have promoted for the last number of years.
Mr.